Hi, my name's Daniel Pemberton, and today I am doing a Reddit AMA. LionMan760, what do you think of the Miguel sound effect being used for memes? I like it a lot. No, I really like the fact that the music you create is being used in a whole different way. In the 80s, you'd write a film soundtrack and it would actually go in the charts. If you look at the charts of like 1981, there is like Ennio Morricone in the chart in the top 10 in Britain and Vangelis, which is crazy. And that kind of stuff doesn't happen anymore. The new way, I guess, is stuff blowing up on TikTok. You know, we had the Prowler from the first film and Miguel 2099 theme being used from this one, both being like weirdly huge TikTok hits. I always used to use a story of Jaws. What I thought was amazing about Jaws was how John Williams wrote a piece of music that changed forever how people thought of sharks. You could be in a restaurant or anywhere and you could sort of say to someone, if you asked anyone in this room what a shark would sound like, everyone would probably hum you the theme from Jaws without even knowing who wrote it. And so that little bit of music sort of lives rent-free in all their heads. I like the fact with Miguel, we've kind of created a weird sound effect. I don't even know how you describe it for how people would now describe canon events. No one previously needed a sound for that, but now there is one that exists, so I love it. What was the brand of a toilet roll? Because it sparked my interest as an Eastern European. They still use a theme I wrote a long time ago for Lotus toilet rolls in Eastern Europe, and they are adverts featuring a giant bear. I do not get any free toilet rolls, sadly. Who's your favorite Spider-Man? I'm probably very biased in that I would probably say Miles, because he was my first Spider-Man that I ever wrote music for. And also I love Miles, he's so cool and fun. But I would probably say the one I'm closest to is probably Peter B. Parker, in that he's slightly out of shape and getting on a bit. There's a couple of lines in this movie which sadly really resonated with me based on how Peter's physique was doing.